Yes, welcome back to the welding sessions. We are solving the problems in the previous class. Now we'll solve the different problems which will be coming for the examinations using the strength. Depending upon the strength, how can we calculate the size of the weld? As per the IS 800, we will be solving the problems in this class. Okay, so we'll go for the different problems. Each different problems will be of different types only. They are not similar types. Try to solve the some more problems in the textbooks. Okay, only a typical examples will be solving here. Okay, we continue the questions. Okay, determine the service load permitted on the connection. On the connection shown in figure, assume fillet weld. Sorry, assume field weld and Fe 410 grade steel. So they want to find out the service load permitted on the connection shown in the figure. So let us see the figure. So a plate of 10 by 12 has been connected to a gusset plate of thickness 12 mm. Okay, so this is a weld. Along with the end returns, okay. So there is an plug weld is in there. E41 worker has been used. The die of the plug is being given like this. Look here, it is 30. So it is plug weld, or it is also slot hot weld. So plate of 100 by 12. So GP thickness 12 mm. So along with this, they have given one more like this, showing with an arrow 10 here, then 120. Okay, this what we see D is the size of the weld of this weld, 10 mm, along with the 180, what 120 is the length of this weld. Okay, now we have to determine the service load for this connection. Okay, we will start. So what are the data given? First thing, size of the weld. Then length of the weld has been given. First, always copy the data. That is always very important. We know that the formula. So strength is equal to 0.7D times of L into Fu divided by root 3 divided by gamma MB. That is nothing but allowable stress. So we know that strength is equal to 0.7 times of D, nothing but size of the weld, the length of the weld, into Fu divided by root 3 gamma MW. Now take for this respectively, take 1 millimeter as the length here. Don't take 120 here. Okay, 10 into 1 into stress is, if U is 410 divided by root 3 into gamma MW is 1.5, since it is a field weld. So partial safety factor is 1.5. If it is sharp weld, it is 1.25. Okay, if you calculate this, the strength will be 1104.66 newton per mm. Okay, now do one thing. Now multiply to the total length. So strength provided. By the fillet weld is equal to length into design strength. So length is 120, strength is 1104.66, so it comes to 132.6 kilonewtons. So this is the strength provided for the fillet weld. Okay, so length into design strength. Okay, so this is the strength of the fillet. Now, so look at the section here. So it is a plate along with the weld and along with the plug. So the total design strength is based on the weld. So how to calculate this total strength? First, strength of this fillet weld along with the design strength of the plug of the 30 mm diameter. So both are contributing the connection, correct? So total design strength is based on the weld is equal to first is strength of fillet weld plus design strength of the plug. So the plug dia has been given there as 30 mm. Now find out the design strength of the plug. It is simple. So strength of the plug weld is equal to area into strength. So area pi by 4 into d square is 30 square. The strength will be 410 divided by root 3 into 1.5. So it comes to 111.458 kilonewtons. Okay, once you get the plug welding strength, so total design strength has to be calculated. So design strength, so total design strength is equal to the 111.458 plus 132.6, both you have it, so you get 244.148 kilonewtons. So total design strength has been obtained. Now calculate the tension capacity of the plate. So tension capacity of the plate see always keep in mind the tension capacity of the plate should be always greater than the this design strength. Got it? So how to tell tension capacity is simple. You know that TDG is equal to AG into FY divided by gamma M naught. So this is given the page number 32 of class 6.2 of IS 800. So it is AG is cross area of the plate 100 into 12. FY is 250 for Fe 410 steel and gamma M naught is 1.1. You calculate this. 272.72 kilonewtons is what the total tension capacity of the plate, which is greater than the total design strength, that is 244.148. Obviously, it is safe. Correct. Now, service load is equal to total strength divided by factor of safety. So total strength is 244.148 divided by 1.5. So service load is 162 kilonewtons. So this is how we'll calculate the steps. Okay, this is one type of problem. So next problem, design a fillet weld to join a tension member of ISMC 250 at 30.4 kg per meter to a 10 mm thick gusset plate, service tensile load is 600 kilonewtons. Use Fe 540 grade steel, E55 electrodes. The weld has to be done for the following case. First one, for two sides only. For all three sides, so assume shop weld. This is a problem they have given you. Design a fillet weld to join a tension member of ISMC 250 at 30.4 kg per meter to a 10 mm thick gusset plate. Service tensile load is 600 kilonewtons. Use Fe 540 grade steel, E55 electrode. The weld has been done in two cases. One is for two sides only and three sides only. Assume shaft welding. So the figure they have given like this. The gusset plate. ISMC, C stands for the channel, C section. If they don't give figure also, first put the figure always so that you can understand the problem. So ISMC C section. Okay, this is your ISMC 250. So if you put the look from this side, and this here to look like this, okay. Your eye view is like this automatically. Okay, so the gusset plate looks like this. So this is another plate of 10 mm thick. So this will be your 250, the overall depth. Okay. Now we have to solve. So what we will do is go to the SP6 page 6 for ISMC. The details of ISMC, everything will be given. Just note on like this from the steel table or SP6. Okay, the thickness of the flange, it is 14.1 mm. Thickness of the web, it is 7.1 mm, sorry. Fy is 540 Newton per mm square. Then, I have given you the question. P is 600 kilonewtons. So PU is 600 into 1.5, so it is 900 kilonewtons. Gamma MW is 1.25. Okay, then minimum size of weld, we know that it is 3 mm. Then maximum size, it is, see, when I want to calculate the maximum size of the weld, thickness of the web minus gap is 1.5. before starting the problems, I have told how the weld will be, how to carry gap and all. So it is 1.5 always. So it is 7.1 is the thickness of the web minus gap is 1.5. It is 5.6 mm. I cannot give the 5.6 mm, round it up to a number. So what I will do is, hence I will adopt 5 mm weld. You can go for 6 mm also, but not required. Go for 5 mm, it's enough. Okay, now first, once you get the size, you might calculate the strength of the weld. It is very important. Strength of the weld, this is WD is equal to 0.7 times of D into Fu divided by root 3 gamma MW. Length is taken as 1 year. So 0.7 into 5 into 540. Whole thing there, root 3 into 1.25. So it is 972.95 per mm. So per mm, I'm calculating. So only I took L as 1. Okay. So per mm, it is 872.95. That is the strength of the weld. Now, what I should do? There are two conditions. One is welding is done for the only two sides. So what you calculate both length, first thing, on the both sides, how much I should give them. Then go for the three sides. Okay. So case one, welding is done on two sides. So required length of 5 mm size weld is equal to PU divided by strength, correct? So L is equal to 900 power of 3 divided by FW. Is strength of weld is 872.95. So 1030.98 mm. Okay, then length of weld on each side will be pretty simple, two sides, so divided by 2. So 1030.98 divided by 2, it is 515.49 mm. I cannot stop here because I usually know all of that. If you give only the per length, you will be in the problem. There may be a chance of removal. The weld may get removed. So what to do? Add up the end returns always. So add two lengths of each side along with the end returns. So therefore, total length on each side is equal to 515.49 plus 2 times the size of the weld, nothing but the 5, this is end returns. So 525.49, round off it to 530 mm, so give 530 mm weld on the both sides. So show this typical, the typical graph figure. So this will be your weld of 5 mm with a length of 530. So this is your ISMC 250 at 30.4 kN meter. This is your service load 900 kN. So from here to here will be 125. You know, this half. We can now show the weld. So 5 mm of length 530 with an E55 electrode. So 10 mm thick. That's all. Like this, so you should write. Got it. So for case 1 completed. Now case 2. Before going to case 2, we have to check the block shear failure for the welding. Always it's very important. We know how to calculate the block shear failure. Correct. So check for block shear. So first calculate AVG, AVN both will be same in welding. So AVG is gross area. So 530 into 10 into 2. So it is 5600 mm². ATN is the other area. It is 250 into 10, so 2500 mm². Now TDB1 is equal to AVG FY divided by gamma M naught plus 0.9 times of ATN FU divided by gamma ML. So AVG is 1060 into 410 whole thing divided by 3 into 1.1 into 1000 conversion factor, 0.9 into 2500 to 540 divided by 1.25 into 1000. So TDB1 is equal to 3253.05 kilonewtons. So this value should be greater than the PU value, that is very important, otherwise it is wrong. TDP2 is equal to 0.9 AVN FU divided by root 3 gamma ML plus ATG into FY divided by gamma M naught. So So 0.9 into 10600 into 540, whole thing divided by root 3 into 1.25 into 1000 plus 2500 into 410, whole thing divided by 1.1 into 1000. It comes to 331.24 kilometers. It is TDB 2. So TDB 1, TDB 2, both are greater than PU, therefore it is safe. Got it. So this is how case 1 is solved. See, whatever you do, first you will calculate the take this. You will take the data from the steel table. Then we'll calculate the strength of the fillet weld. Once you calculate the strength of the fillet weld, we'll calculate the, we'll consume that it is welding is done on two sides or three sides, two sides they have asked. So find out the length of the weld, add up the total, the end returns, find out the total length of the weld, round it off, then check for the block shear. If TDB1 and TDB2 permits or it is greater than the factor load, then it is safe. Okay, now we'll solve this in whenever the weld is in given for the three sides. Okay. So case 2, welding is done on three sides. So required length of weld, so it is 5 mm. So required length of 5 mm weld is equal to PU minus 250 into 872.95, whole thing divided by 872.95. So it is 780.98 mm. Correct. So this is 872.95 is your strength of the weld. So 250 is the depth. Correct. So 250 into length strength of the weld, whole thing divided by the strength of the weld into whole thing minus PO will give you the answer as 780.98. This is the strength of the weld of 5 mm. Now on each side, how much I should take? I should calculate. So each length, required length of weld on each side. So it is 780.98, whole thing divided by two sides, it is 390.49 mm. Okay, so total length on each side is equal to 390.49 plus 2 times of weld, so it is 400.49 mm, 405 mm. Got it. So now see, why did I do this? Already, because on the three sides, so this is 250 fixed, whereas this side is said to be calculated. Okay, so 405 is the weld required length of the weld. So why is one side is already 250. The length here, so it is fixed. The remaining length you have to calculate for 300. So only we calculated it as total strength minus 250 is already represented in the strength of the weld divided by total strength of the weld. We will get the required length. So the remaining two sides, 780 divided by 2, we get 309.45 plus 2 times of the 500 tons, it is 405. Okay, this is how we are supposed to calculate the strength of the weld. Okay, now put up the sketch. your section. This is your buzzer plate. This is your weld. So all three sides you have supposed to weld. Okay, so this is your 10 mm thick plate and nothing but the other plate. So this is ISMC 250, 30.4 kg per meter. This is your 900 kilonewtons. It will be acting at the center of 125 mm. Okay, so this is your 5 mm weld of length 405 of E55. So sorry, this is 5. So now check for the block shear. So AVG, gross area, net area, both will be same in welding. So 405 is the length into the 10 mm thickness of the plate into two sides. So it is 800 in square. So ATN, AV, ATV, ATG both are same. So it is 250 into 10 into 10. So it is 2500 mm square. Now calculate TDB1 and TDB2, you know the formula. Direct substituting 100 into 410, so by root 3 into 1.1 into 1000 plus 0.9 times of 2500 into 540 divided by 0.25 into 1000, so it is 2715.07 kilonewtons. So this is TDP 1. TDP 2 will be equal to 0.9 times of 800 into 540, whole thing of the root 3 into 1.25 into 1000 plus 2500 into 410, whole thing divided by 1.1 into 1000, so it is 2750.05. You are getting the answer kilonewtons. So both are TDP are greater than the PO, hence it is safe against block shear. This side will solve the problems on two sides and the three sides. Next, one more different kind of problem. We are using the angle sections. Okay. So here I will be teaching you how to do the design of the fillet weld in three sides and the back to back angle, how to weld it. Next question, design a fillet weld of three sides and side welding, they have mentioned the bracket welded, to join a tension member consisting of two ISA 100 by 75 into 10 mm to a 12 mm thick gusset plate to a 12 mm thick gusset plate. The service tensile load, the service tensile load is 410 kilonewtons. Use Fe 540 grade steel. Use Fe 540 grade steel and E55 grade electrode. Design a fillet weld, which is the three sides and side welding, to be joined a tension member of consisting of two ISA angle of ISA intentional angle 100 by 75 by 10 mm to a 12 mm thick gusset plate. The service tensile load is 410 kilonewtons. Use Fe 540 grade steel and E55 grade electrode. They have not given any figure. So tension member fillet welding, two ISA angle, so the gusset plate, so you can do like this figure. So this is your gusset plate and this back to back two ISA angle have been, that too it is an unequal angle. Okay, now this is gusset plate, this is your ISA angle. Okay, so if you look from this side, so it will be figure looks like this. Imagination is very important, my dear friends. So this is your angle. For this angle, a gusset plate has been attached. Okay, this is your 2 ISA 100 by 75 by 10. Okay, now P is 410 kilonewtons. So convert into PU, it is 410 into 1.5, so it is 615 kilonewtons. See, look at this. Due to the IA2 angles, loads will be divided. See, there are two angles which has to be taken care of this 615 kilonewtons, two angles. So we are not supposed to design, we need not worry about the two angles. So if you design one angle, it's enough. Okay, design that. So for design consideration, do one thing. You can select one angle with the divided by, the load can be divided by two. Since there are two angles, the total load will be divided by two, correct? If two persons are there, one apple is there, we'll divide into two, correct? Same concept here also. So total load is 4615 kilonewtons. Two angles are there, so divided by two. So due to the two angles, load will be shared. Will be shared by two plates, with two sides of gusset plate welding. Therefore, design PU is equal to 615 divided by 2, so it is 307.5 kilonewton. Okay, now we know the welding concept. First thing we should to find out the design size of the weld. So minimum size of the weld, minimum size of the weld 3 mm. So maximum size of the weld, so thickness of the plate minus 1/4 of the size of the plate, so it is 7.5 mm. We have two concepts. One is 1.5 gap, or it is thickness minus 1/4 of the thickness of the plate taken. You can take whichever is the relevant, you can say take it depending upon situation. So 7.5 is high, so adopt 6 mm size of the वर्ल्ड, ओके। सो इट इज 6 mm साइज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड। सो व्हाट विल डू नाउ, सो इमीडिएटली कैलकुलेट द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द वर्ल्ड पर mm। स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द वर्ल्ड एफ डब्ल्यू डी 0.7 टाइम्स ऑफ डी एफ यू डिवाइड बाई रूट 3 गामा एम डब्ल्यू। सो 0.7 इंटू साइज इज 6 इंटू 540 इज यूर एफ यू डिवाइड बाई रूट 3 इंटू 1.5। सो इट इज साइट बिल्डिंग, सो इट 1.5 इट इज 872.95 न्यूटन पर mm। So length is taken, calculated as taking as a 1 mm. So it is strength will be per newton per mm. Now once you do this, so we have to do the welding on all three sides. So welding is done on all three sides. So required length of the weld is equal to similar thing of last problem. So PU minus one side, it is already fixed, it is 75 into 872.95, whole thing divided by 872.95. Okay, got it. So connecting leg is 100, outstanding leg is 175. So 100 into 75, second one is 75. So one side it is 75. Remaining two sides you have to suppose to calculate here. Okay, so it is 277.25 mm. So required length of the of weld on each one of each side is equal to 277.25 divided by 2, so it is 138.62 mm. So this is the side of the weld on the either side. So add up the end returns here, so therefore total length on each side, so it is 138.62 plus 2 times this size of the weld, so it is 150.62 mm. So you can take it round off it to 155 mm. Okay, now represent this in the figure. This is your gusset plate, this is your angle section, so your welding will be done here also, and so it's also, this is your cassette plate, so 12 mm cassette plate. See, whatever you do, you should show so this is your welding portion. So six mm weld with 155 length with E55 electrode. This is the how it represents. Once you represent this, check for the block shear. So check for block shear. So ABG is equal to ABN, both are same. So this is 155 length into 12 is the thickness of the plate into 2. So it is 3720 mm square. Now ATG and ATN. So 75 into 12. So it is 900 mm square. If you substitute with the formula TDB1, 3720 into 410 FA divided by 410 into root 3 to 1.1 into 1000 plus 0.9 into 900 into 540, whole thing divided by 1.25 for factor of safety into 1000 conversion factor. I'm getting it as 1150.44 kilonewtons. Similarly, this will be very easy. Just go on substituting it in the formulas which is given the page number 33 of IS 800. 540 whole thing divided by root 3 into 1.25 into 1000 plus 900 into 410 whole thing divided by 1.1 into 1000. So it is 1170.46 kiloton. So TDB is greater than PU, hence the section is safe. So this is how we'll be using whenever they give you ISA angle. This is how we should do the problems. Okay, next thing is the bracket connection. This is very important connection. The bracket connection, eccentric connections, we studied in the bolted connections also. When it is eccentricity which is perpendicular to plane and parallel to plane, there are two conditions here. Okay, before that we'll determine how to calculate the how to design the what are the procedure for four side welding or three side welding. We'll discuss this. Okay, so whenever you design any problem or welding which we are supposed to design on the three sides or four sides. Okay, so it is a standard procedure. If you solve while doing the problem or solving the problem, if you follow this procedure, it will be easy to design the section. Okay, so what are the design procedures for four sides or three sides welding? Okay, this is a procedure. So whenever you want to start anything, whenever first thing is, first locate the center of the weld groove. If it is four sides which has just been welded, the symmetrical axis forms the at the center. If it is three sides, then find out the locate the center and do the formula. Okay, so first thing is location of the or locate center of the welded groove. If four sides are welded, then symmetrical axis forms the centroid. Okay, if it is three sides, are welded, then you are supposed to then locate x bar, nothing but your centroid. Okay. Second thing, length of the weld. So length of the weld, it is simple. So four sides, L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4. If it is three sides, similarly, L1 plus L2 plus L3, both will be L1. Length of the weld. Next thing is load due to direct shear. So same old formula, Fp is equal to P divided by L. The second, next thing, load due to, or calculate the torsional moment M is equal to P into E, where E is the eccentricity. Okay, same old thing what we did in the world connection, so same thing here also. Polar moment of inertia. Of weld, Ip is equal to Ix plus Iy. Okay, then one more force, you know, that is torsional shear, load due to torsional shear. So Fm is equal to M into R divided by Ip. I will teach you how to find out the R. Once again, I will repeat when I am doing the welded problems. The last thing is resultant force in weld, that is R. The same old formula, R is equal to square root of Fp square plus Fm square plus 2 times of Fp Fm cos theta. Okay, once you get this resultant force, R is equal to square root of Fp square plus Fm square plus 2p Fp Fm cos theta. Now last step is, you have to suppose to equate the resultant force R to the strength of the weld to determine size of the weld. Nothing but D. So R is equal to 0.7 times of D into Fu divided by root 3 gamma Mw. D can be calculated. Okay, this is the procedure for the forceful tracer welding for the eccentric connections. So how it will be four-side or three-side welding, when you see the figure, the bracket connection. So if it is three sides welding, it looks like this. So bracket connected, plate. Path. Okay, if the P is here, if this is the E, your three sides welding, you have to do here. Okay. Now this is three sides. One more is four sides. Same thing, but only one thing is, one more side also we are supposed to weld, other side also. P and this is E. Now you are supposed to weld on four sides. First, second side, third side, and lastly, welding over here also. So this is four sides welded. So whenever in next class we'll solve how to calculate the problem when the eccentric connection or the bracket connection has been given, when it is the moment is acting parallel to the plane or it is acting the perpendicular to the plane. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you.